And we'll discover together, well, the plural form, how to construct or how to make a plural form. So it's le pluriel en français. So let's start now. So we'll take this example, okay, basic example. A friend, un ami, okay, un ami. Okay, so here you can see that we've got this article indéfini, un, the masculine form, singular form, and then we've got ami, friend, like that, at the singular form as well. So if we want to construct the plural form, well, obviously the article will change, okay? We saw previously that the plural article was des, in that case, and then we keep the same word, so ami, and the rule goes like that. You've got to add at the end of the word s, okay? In that case, and as in most of the cases, you won't pronounce it, but you will have to put it, okay? And so you've got des amis, okay? And if you make the liaison, so the link between the two, you will get des amis, okay? Des amis. So ami, remember, doesn't change. Even if you've got to write the S, then you don't pronounce it, okay? And now, let's see a few examples. So this one, une femme, okay? So if we think about the rule that we saw previously, then une is changing and then the article become des, okay? Femme, you write it like it was at the singular form and then you just add this S at the end, and as we said, you don't pronounce it, so you get des femme, okay? Des femmes. So une femme, singular, and then des femmes, right? And then un homme, if we make this little link between the two, un homme, un homme, un homme, and then we'll put this word at the plural form. So same thing here, so this article indéfini un is becoming des in that case, and then you rewrite the word homme, and after that you just put the S at the end. You don't pronounce it, so you get des hommes, des hommes, des hommes, okay? Un homme, singular form, des hommes, plural form, okay? And then I took, well, this example with this article défini le, okay, so the, le livre, okay, if you want to put the plural form, then the article here becomes les, so that's the plural form, okay, les, and then same rule, you just write livre, and then you put S at the end, but then you don't pronounce it, les livres, le livre, les livres. So it's quite interesting in this example here, because if you listen carefully, le livre, les livres, so the only way to know whether it's singular or plural is to pronounce correctly the article, in that case, le, and here, les. So it's really this le, and then les, that will make the difference between the singular form and the plural form, okay? As usual in French, we've got exceptions. So you get words that will end with this E, A, U, combination of vowels, like, for instance, une, O. So remember, when you get these vowels like that, then you get only the sound O, okay? Une, O. So in that case, well, you won't add the S as like we saw previously, but then it will be, the rule is that you've got to put X here at the end, but then same rule, you don't pronounce it. Des eaux, okay? Une eau, des eaux, all right? Second group, words ending with A, U. Here is an example. Un tuyau, okay, same rule here, you won't add S at the end, but instead of S you will put X, Okay? Des tuyaux. Same rule, you don't pronounce it. Des tuyaux. Okay? Un tuyau, des tuyaux. So the only difference will be with the article because the word will be pronounced the same way. And then the last group is the words ending with e, u, e. So let's take one example. Un feu, un feu. And basically the same rule. You don't put S, but you will put X instead, and then you don't pronounce it. Des feux. Un feu. Des feux. Okay? There is another group of words. So because normally the words ending with the OU, like that here. OU, and then the sound is OU, okay? Normally these words just behave like the others, so you just need to put S at the end. But of course, as usual in French, we've got few exceptions. So I've been listing all the exceptions of the OU ending, you know, words that will, well, like we saw previously, not take S, but then take X at the end, okay? But still, as usual, it's not pronounced, so it doesn't really affect the pronunciation, but it's just for you if you want to write them correctly at the plural form. Remember, it's not S, but it's X, okay? So the first one, un bijou, okay? So I did put the translation here. Pluriel, des bijoux, okay? Then, un caillou, un caillou, plural, des cailloux. Okay, remember, you don't pronounce it, the final X. Then, un chou, okay, remember, when you combine this C and H, you get the sound sh, sh, sh. Chou, un chou, pluriel, des choux. Okay. Un genou, des genoux. Un hibou, des hiboux, des hiboux. Un joujou, des joujoux, des joujoux. Un pou, des pou, des pou. Okay, so the good thing, if you remember carefully what I've been introducing so far, is that the main group of words are actually, you only need to add S at the end, and then you, well, basically you don't pronounce the S. Or then the exceptions, you will, like these ones here, you will have to add this X at the end, but still you won't pronounce the X, okay? But still, as usual, we've got exceptions. So a few exceptions, not that much, but then these exceptions are really, really strange because it does mean that the pronunciation will change. Okay, so we'll take this one, un bœuf, and then at the plural, well, you just write it like we saw previously, so you just add this S, but then pronunciation changes quite much because you get des bœufs, all right, un bœuf, des bœufs, all right. Then, un œuf, des œufs. Okay, and we'll make the liaison here to make it sound more beautiful. Des œufs, all right? Un œuf, des œufs. And then the last one, this is probably the most strange one. Un œil, un œil, des yeux, des yeux. Yeux, yeux, ok? Don't pronounce the final X as usual. Yeux, yeux, des yeux. Alright? Discover together. Le verbe pouvoir. Pouvoir means to can, ok? So it's quite useful. And then we'll discover it because, well, it's not a regular verb, so it's always quite quite interesting to take a few minutes to really work on it and try to remember the way it is conjugated at the present form, okay? So the first form that we'll have is je, as usual. So je peux, okay? Final X not pronounced here, okay? So you've got X, but you don't pronounce it. So basically, you get the sound peu, peu, je peu, okay, so I can, je peux, okay, then tu, tu peux, same pronunciation and same spelling or writing, okay, P-E-U-X, okay, don't pronounce the final X, tu peux, okay, je peux, tu peux, then il, elle peut, so you will put T at the end, you don't pronounce it. Il peut, elle peut. Okay? So if you look carefully, you've got peu here, you've got peu here, and you've got peu here. Okay? So for the three first, or four, because there is the feminine form as well, for the four first persons here, well, it's the same phonetical form. It's peu. Okay? And then nous. So, a classic ending for nous, this ONS ending for nous, okay? Nous pouvons, okay? You don't pronounce the final S, nous pouvons. Mm-hmm. Then, vous pouvez, okay? Classic ending as well for the vous form. A Z like that, okay? Remember, you pronounce it E, okay? Vous pouvez. And then, plural form, ils, elles, peuvent. Ils, elles, peuvent. Okay? So, be careful because, as you can see, you've got this EU here, EU here, EU here, and then it's coming back here as well. Okay? So, the only OU that does connect to the infinitive here. Pouvoir, it's only for nous and vous. Okay? So, let's read them one more time. Je peux. Tu peux, il peut, elle peut, nous pouvons, vous pouvez, ils peuvent, elles peuvent. Okay? As usual, this ending, this ENT ending, you write it, you don't pronounce it. Okay? Peuvent, peuvent, peuvent. Okay? So it's really useful. You should really, I mean, definitely know it by heart. Okay? So try your best. Well, watch again this video if you need it, and then I hope it will enter in your head quite easily. Okay, let's see some example now. Je peux chanter. Okay, je peux chanter. So you can see that in that case, when you construct a verb, you construct a sentence with the verb pouvoir, here you've got a second verb, chanter, and it means to sing, okay? So, I can sing. Well, you should all the time put the second verb at the infinitive form, okay? So, when we talk about infinitive form, normally it's the basic form of the verb, okay? Je peux chanter. Another example. Tu peux partir. Partir is to leave. You can leave. Tu peux partir. All right. Same thing here. Okay. Second verb, well, basically coming right after, of course, and then at the infinitive form. All right. Elle peut dessiner. Dessiner is to draw. Elle peut dessiner. She can draw. Okay. Elle peut dessiner. And in this lesson, we will try to focus on le verbe devoir. Devoir means to must. Okay. So it's quite useful, and especially it's not a regular verb, so it's always good to spend a few minutes on the conjugation at the present of this verb. Okay, so let's start now. Let's see, so le verbe devoir, to must, at the present form. Je dois, Okay, remember, final S is not pronounced. Je dois. O-E, when you combine the two, you get the sound wa wa wa. Je dois. Okay? Tu dois. Final S not pronounced. Tu dois. Il, elle, doit. Final T not pronounced. Il doit. Elle doit. Okay? So if you have a look at these forms phonetically, they are the same forms. Okay? So doit, doit, and then doit. Okay? And then, nous is coming. Nous devons. Okay, classic ending, O-N-S for nous. Okay, you just pronounce this on, O-N, this nasal. Okay, and then the S, final S is not pronounced. Nous devons. Nous devons. Okay, nous devons, well, basically, we must. Okay, and then, vous devez. Remember, classic ending. For vous here, a Z, but then you pronounce this combination of two letters, E, devez, devez, vous devez. All right? And then the last one, ils doivent. So same thing, classic ending for the plural form, E-N-T here. Okay, but then you don't pronounce it. Doivent, doivent, elles doivent, ils doivent. Elles doivent. Okay? So let's repeat them one more time. Je dois. Tu dois. Il doit. Elle doit. Nous devons. Vous devez. Ils doivent. Elles doivent. Alright? So let's see a few examples now. The first one. Je dois étudier. Étudier is to study, okay? So it's a verb. And then the rule in French goes like that. If you've got to put two verbs in a sentence, like here, the second one must be at the infinitive form. So when we talk about the infinitive, it's the basic form of the verb, okay? So étudier, study. Je dois étudier. I must study. Je dois étudier, okay? Then, il doit choisir. Okay, same thing here. Choisir means to choose. Okay, and so I did put here the infinitive form, so the basic form, IR form. Il doit choisir. Okay, he must choose. And the last example, nous devons répondre. Répondre is to answer. Répondre here. Okay. Nous devons répondre. We must answer. Nous devons répondre. Okay? We are going to discover together European countries, so les pays européens. Okay? So let's start now with les pays européens. And the first one, la Grèce. La Grèce. Okay? So remember, gr, gr. And then this accent grave like that, open, Grèce, okay? La Grèce. Le Portugal. Le Portugal. L'Espagne. L'Espagne. Okay, don't insist on the final E because basically it's not pronounced. L'Espagne. Nye, nye, nye. L'Espagne. L'Espagne. L'Italie, l'Italie, l'Italie. Okay, so you can see that for these two countries here, as they are starting with a vowel, like here, okay, as we saw in a previous lesson, the article is modified and then it's L apostrophe, like that, okay? Le Luxembourg. Okay, final G not pronounced, and then when you combine this E, M here, you get the sound en, en. You don't pronounce the M at all, it's this nasal en, okay? Le Luxembourg. Le Luxembourg. Okay? La France. La France. Okay? A-N here, nasal en, en. La France. Okay, we continue. Les Pays-Bas. Final S here, not pronounced. Same thing here. Pays, pays, and then bas. Les Pays-Bas. Okay. Then l'Irlande. Remember, this is E and it should pronounce, it should be pronounced like E, E. Irlande. Irlande. Okay, A-N-A-N-D. And final E, not pronounced. Irlande. Le Royaume-Uni. Le Royaume-Uni. Le Royaume-Uni. OK. L'Allemagne. L'Allemagne. Nya, 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 nya. Remember this G, N, E. It can be quite tricky at the beginning to produce, I mean, the sound, nya, okay? But really, you should work on that because it's quite, well, it's not coming all the time, but it's not rare. I mean, the sound is not rare in French, okay? Nya. L'Allemagne. L'Allemagne. Okay? La Belgique. Okay, remember, Q, U, E here. You will get only the sound K, K. Okay? Belgique. Belgique. So it's not Belgique, not at all, okay? Because it's only the k, k, Belgique, okay? Le Danemark. So same sound here, this k and then this q, u, e. Well, they will produce the same sound here. Belgique, le Danemark, okay? L'Autriche, okay? Remember, sh, sh here. L'Autriche, l'Autriche, ok. La Suède, d, d, la Suède, Suède. Remember, accent grave, it's really open, e, su, e, Suède, Suède, la Suède. La Finlande, I-N here, nasal, un. A-N, nasal, en, and then D, final E, not pronounced. La Finlande. Okay. L'Estonie, final E, not pronounced. L'Estonie. L'Estonie. La Lettonie. So remember, when you've got this E, and then a double letter like that, T, T, okay, then you will have to open your E, and it will become E, le, Lettonie, la, Lettonie, la, Lituanie. Remember in French, sorry, H doesn't exist, okay, so you don't pronounce it, and it's li, tu, a, ni, Lituanie, la, Lituanie, okay. Continues. La Pologne. Nya, nya, again. La Pologne. La République Tchèque. So remember, Q, U, E, K, K, Tchèque. La, and then here as well, République, K, la République Tchèque. Okay, la République Tchèque. Chypre. Chypre. So remember, we've got this Y letter here, but then phonetically, when you pronounce it, it's like I, okay? Chi, Chypre, okay? Malte. Same thing here, you don't insist on the final E. Malte. Malte. La Slovénie. Remember, you get this E accent aigu here, it's E, E. Slovénie, final E, as usual, not pronounced. La Slovénie, okay? La Hongrie. So remember, H doesn't exist, so you don't pronounce it. So it starts with O-N, on, on, and then gris, gris, final E, not pronounced. La Hongrie, la Hongrie, okay? les nationalités. So basically, I've been making this nationalities lesson based on the previous lesson. So leçon D, okay? So I definitely invite you to check the leçon D if you want that everything is clear for you, okay? But then les nationalités, and it's starting right now. La Grèce. Grec, so I will put each time the masculine form for the nationality, Grec, and the feminine form here for the nationality, okay? So you get the country, la Grèce, and then you get Grec, masculine form, Grec, feminine form. You write them differently, but then if you listen carefully, Grec, Grec, you pronounce them the same way, okay? Le Portugal. Portugais, portugaise. Okay, so listen carefully. Portugais, portugaise. The only difference between the two, as usually when we'll have some, well, nationalities ending with A-E-S, like that, E, and then the feminine form, es, okay? It will be only in this Z sound, the difference between the masculine form and the feminine form, okay? Masculine, portugais. You don't pronounce the S, feminine form, portugaise, you pronounce this Z sound, okay? And then, l'Espagne, espagnol, gne gne gne, remember, espagnol, espagnol. So you get this final E for the feminine form, but then phonetically it's the same. L'Italie, italien, italienne. Remember, when you get this E, followed by a double consonant like here, then you will have to open it. E, italienne, italienne. Okay? Le Luxembourg, luxembourgeois, luxembourgeois, and then feminine form, luxembourgeoise. Okay? Same thing here, only difference, joie, joie. Joise, z, z, okay, you insist on it. Luxembourgeois, masculine form, and then luxembourgeoise, feminine form. Then, la France, français, française, okay, c'est, and then seize, okay, français, française, all right, it continues. Les Pays-Bas, néerlandais, néerlandaise, néerlandais, néerlandaise, ok. L'Irlande, irlandais, irlandaise. Le Royaume-Uni, britannique, ok. Only one form, whether it's masculine or feminine, britannique. L'Allemagne, allemand, allemande. Okay, same thing here. En, okay, you don't pronounce the final D, but then you pronounce it here for the feminine form. Allemande, d, d, okay? Allemand, allemande. La Belgique, belge. So only one form here for the masculine and the feminine form. Le Danemark, danois, danoise, z, hein? Okay, insist on that. Danois, don't pronounce the final S, danoise, here you pronounce it. L'Autriche, autrichien, autrichienne. So same thing here, you get E and then double N, you open the E, E, autrichienne. Okay, autrichien, autrichienne. La Suède, suédois, suédoise. Okay, suédois, suédoise. La Finlande, finlandais, finlandaise. Finlandais, finlandaise. l'Estonie, estonien, estonienne. Same thing here, double N, E, and then you open it. E, estonienne, estonienne. La Lettonie, letton, lettonne, letton, lettonne. La Lituanie, lituanien, lituanienne. Same thing here. You open the A. A. Lituanienne. OK? Lituanien, lituanienne. La Pologne, polonais, polonaise. Polonais, polonaise. La République tchèque, tchèque. Okay, so here as well, you get only one nationality. So whether for masculine or feminine form, it will be the same. Tchèque. Okay. Chypre, same thing here. Chypriote. She, remember this Y is pronounced like I. Okay. Chypriote. Chypriote. Okay. Malte, Maltais, Maltese. So remember, as I said previously, the only difference est, es. Maltais, Maltese. La Slovénie, so only one form here, Slovène, Slovène. Remember, E accent grave, you open it, est, Slovène. La Hongrie, hongrois, hongroise. Okay, hongrois, grois, hongroise. Okay, so here, final S not pronounced for the masculine form, and then you pronounce it here for the feminine form. Hongrois, hongroise. Okay, les Amériques, les Amériques. So let's see now. Les États-Unis. Okay, so if we make every links, we'll have it here and then here. Okay, les États-Unis, les États-Unis. Le Canada, le Canada. Le Mexique, le Mexique. X, Mexique. It's really the X. Hein? Le Mexique. And then remember this Q-U-E, it's only K. Mexique. Okay. Le Brésil. Le Brésil. Okay, you will pronounce the final L here. And then remember, accent aigu goes like E. Bré. Brésil. Le Brésil. L'Argentine. Okay, so you've got this nasal here. En, l'argent, and then tin, tin. Don't pronounce the final E. It just gives you the pronunciation of the N. In, in. L'Argentine. L'Argentine. Le Chili. Le Chili. Okay, remember, CH, ch. Okay, chi, Chili. La Bolivie. Okay, final E, not pronounced. La Bolivie. La Bolivie. All right, so I assume everything is clear. We can repeat them one more time. Les États-Unis, le Canada, le Mexique, le Brésil, l'Argentine. Le Chili, la Bolivie. Okay, and then we'll see now the nationality. So you will see here each time first the masculine form and then the feminine form. Okay, so les États-Unis, américain. So when you talk about the nationality, américain, masculine form, un, américain. And then feminine form, américaine. Américaine. Okay, it's really open, this A-I. Eh, américaine. Okay? Le Canada, canadien, yin, here, canadien, canadienne, yen. Remember, here you've got double N, so you've got to open the so it will become a canadienne. Okay? Le Mexique, mexicain, un, here, like we had in américain, A-I-N, mexicain, and then mexicaine, mexicaine. Le Brésil, brésilien, yin, brésilien, like we had for canadien, brésilien, feminine form, brésilienne, yen, yen, brésilienne. Okay. And then l'Argentine, argentin, IN gives you this un sound, argentin, okay, and then Argentine, Argentine. Okay, if you look carefully, well, basically the feminine form is the same as the name of the country. Okay. Le Chili, chilien, chilien, yin, chilien, chilienne, chilienne. Okay, and then la Bolivie, bolivien, yin, same, bolivien, and then feminine form, bolivienne, bolivienne. Okay, this lesson we'll discover together le verbe attendre. So attendre means to wait. Okay, so it belongs to the third group of verbs, so not the regular one, the irregular. So that's the reason why it's quite important to take a few minutes to discover together the way to conjugate this verb at the present form. Okay, so let's see now how it will go. So the first form will be j'attends. J'attends. Okay, you get D and S, well, basically you don't pronounce them, okay, and then you get only the sound attends, nasal here, en, j'attends, okay. Second form, tu attends, okay, you can see that, well, it is exactly the same one, so same way to pronounce it, attends, okay. Il attend, elle attend. So the only difference between this one, so this il form and the tu or je form, okay, if you want to write, it's just that if you look carefully, you don't have the final S here, okay? But then basically, if you want to only pronounce or only speak, then, well, it's exactly the same way to pronounce these forms, okay? J'attends, tu attends, il attend, elle attend. Okay, but then nous is coming here, all right, and then we've got the classic ending for nous, so O-N-S, okay, you don't pronounce the S, so you get only this on sound, okay, attendons, nous attendons, so we'll make the link between the two, la liaison, nous attendons, vous form, same thing, classic ending for vous, EZ, okay. When you combine the two, you get the sound E, okay. Vous attendez, attendez, okay. Let's put here the liaison, the link. Vous attendez, okay. And the last one, same thing, classic ending for il, elle at the plural form, ENT, but then you don't pronounce them. Ils attendent, d, okay, so remember you get to pronounce this, d, at the end, okay. Elles attendent, alright, if you make the link, ils attendent, elles attendent, okay. So let's read them. J'attends, tu attends, il attend, elle attend, nous attendons. Vous attendez, ils attendent, elles attendent. Okay? So I've been making few sentences just to show you how it works or the meaning. J'attends le train. So le train, the train, I wait, okay? I wait for the train, but then j'attends le train. Okay? Tu attends avec moi. So you wait, and then avec means with, moi, me. You wait with me. Tu attends avec moi. Il attend sa femme. Okay, remember, sa, it's the possessive, his in that case, and then femme, wife. Il attend sa femme. Nous attendons tranquillement. Nous attendons tranquillement. So here, I wanted to show you how it could work if you put this tranquillement. So tranquillement is quietly, and it's an adverb. Okay, it's ending with ment like that, which is one of the classic ending for the adverbs. We'll have the time to see that a bit later. But then, yeah, quietly is tranquillement. Nous attendons tranquillement. So basically, you put this adverb after your verb. Okay? Nous attendons tranquillement. Vous attendez les enfants. Okay, children, les enfants. Vous attendez les enfants. Elles attendent votre réponse. Réponse, answer, and then remember, votre, it's the possessive, your. Elles attendent votre réponse. Okay? So I will read them one more time, and I will read them at my normal speed. Okay? Just for you to get used. Because I've been reading them quite slowly when we were just we were covering them previously. Okay? So, j'attends le train, tu attends avec moi, il attend sa femme, nous attendons tranquillement, vous attendez les enfants, elles attendent votre réponse. Le verbe répondre. Répondre means to answer, so it's quite useful. And then, it belongs to the third group of verbs, so we'll see how to conjugate this verb répondre at the present form. So let's see now the first form. Je réponds. Je réponds. Okay, so you can see that D and S here are not pronounced. Je réponds. Okay. Tu réponds. Well, the same form. Okay, exactly the same form, so the same pronunciation. Tu réponds. Il répond. So, final D is not pronounced. You only have this on nasal sound at the end. Répond. Elle répond. Okay. So, je réponds, tu réponds, il répond, elle répond. Okay. So far, only one way to pronounce it. All right. Then, of course, for nous, we've got the normal and classic ending ons. Okay. Don't pronounce the final s. You only pronounce this on sound. So you get répondons. Nous répondons. Nous répondons. Okay, and then classic ending for vous as well, EZ, okay. Remember, you combine these two letters, you get the sound E. So, répondez. Vous répondez. Vous répondez. Okay, and then the last persons here, ils répondent. So same thing here, classic ending ENT, but then you don't pronounce it. Okay? Répondent. Ils répondent. Elles répondent. Okay? So let's see all the form one more time. Je réponds. Tu réponds. Il répond. Elle répond, nous répondons, vous répondez, ils répondent, elles répondent. All right? Hier, yesterday, aujourd'hui, today, demain, tomorrow. OK? Hier, yesterday, aujourd'hui, today, demain, tomorrow. So let's see now. Hier, so yesterday. Hier matin. Matin is morning. Okay, so yesterday morning will go in French like hier matin. Hier matin. Okay. Après-midi means afternoon. Hier après-midi. Yesterday afternoon. Hier après-midi. Hier après-midi. All right. And then soir, evening. Hier soir. Hier soir. Okay, so let's repeat that. Hier. Hier matin. Hier après-midi. Hier soir. Okay. So now, aujourd'hui. Today. Aujourd'hui. Ce matin. So we put here this ce, this matin, morning, this morning, ce matin, cet après-midi, this afternoon, cet après-midi, cet après-midi, ce soir, so soir evening, this evening. Ce soir. Ce soir. All right? And then, demain, so tomorrow. Demain matin, tomorrow morning. Demain matin. Demain après-midi, tomorrow afternoon. Demain après-midi. Demain soir. Demain soir, tomorrow evening, demain soir. So one more time. Hier, hier matin, hier après-midi, hier soir, aujourd'hui, ce matin, cet après-midi, ce soir, demain, demain matin, demain après-midi, demain soir. 50, de 50 à 75, till 75, de 50 à 75. So let's see how they go. 50, 50, 51, 51, 52, 52, 53, 53, 54, 54, 55, 55, 56, 56, 57, 57, 58, 58, 59, 59, 60, 60, 61, 61, 62, 62, 63, 63, 64, 64, 65, 65, 66, 66, 67, 67, 68, 68, 69, 69. And that's normally when my students, when I'm in class with them, start to look at me like they would like to kill me, because now we're getting to the tricky point in French, okay? So have a look here. Now we've got this 70, of course. But then in French, it's a bit more tricky because you take back the 60, 60, and then you will add the 10, 10, okay? So for this 70 session here, you will have to use this 60 and then 10. And so all the numbers from 10 to 19, you will have to put them right here after. Okay, so let's see how it goes. 70, 70, 71, 71. Okay, so you can see here now. 60, 60, and then 11, 11. 71. 72. 72. Same thing here. 60, and then 12. Okay? 73. 73. 74. 74. 75. 75. Okay, so we won't go further, not to be more traumatized, because I've got some nice surprises after that as well. Okay, so remember that, well, till 70, well, it's quite not easy, because it's always difficult to remember the numbers, but still it's not that tricky. Okay, so remember that for 70 here, so from 70 to 79, you will have to use this 60, so 60, and then the numbers from 10 to 19. Okay, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, etc. So we'll see the rest in a coming lesson. So now what we'll do, we'll go to till 100, and then we'll see all the tricky and irregular forms. Okay, so if you remember, when we stopped, it was here. Okay, so 75 in French, we'll have to use this 60, so 60. Okay, and then after that you will have to put this 15, 15. Okay, so remember, from 70 to 79, it will work the same way. So you will have to put this 60 and then the numbers from 10 to 19 after. Sorry, yeah, 19, yes. Okay, so in that case it's 75, 75, okay, 60, and then 15. Okay, next one, 76. Okay, so 60 and 16. Okay, 76. All right. 77. 77. 78. 78. 79. 79. And then 80. Okay, so for 80, it's 80, 80, all right? 81, 81, 82, 82, 83, 83, 84, 84, 85, 85, 86, 86, 87, 87. 88, 88, 89, 89. And now for 90, well, basically it would be the same thing as we had for 70. So you will take this 80, 80, and then you will add the numbers from 10 to 19 after. So 90, and then 91, so 91. So remember 80, 80, and then 11, 11. 91, 92, 92, 93, 93, 94, 94, 95, 95, 96, 96, 97, 97, 98, 98, 99, 99, and the last one, 100. Remember, final T, not pronounced. 100. Okay? Discover this parce que form. So, parce que means because. Okay? And it's really, really useful. So, we'll see how to use it. Okay? So, parce que here. So, the first use of parce que is when you want to introduce the reason. Okay? So, we've got two examples here. Il ne mange pas. Pas tout de suite. Okay, so here you've got the negative form, remember, ne, and then pas. Manger means to eat. Il ne mange pas, so he doesn't eat. Tout de suite, well, basically it means right now. Parce qu'il, okay, préfère attendre. So in that case, because he prefers to wait. Il préfère attendre. Okay? Préférer to prefer. And then here, you can see that attendre is to wait. Second verb, okay? And then you should put it like here at the infinitive form. So the basic form of the verb. Okay? Il ne mange pas tout de suite parce qu'il préfère attendre. Okay, second example, nous allons dehors, aller is to go, dehors, outside. Nous allons dehors, so we go outside, parce que, so because, nous voulons marcher, vouloir, to want, marcher, to walk. Nous voulons marcher, we want to walk. Okay, nous allons dehors parce que nous voulons marcher. Okay? And then, the second option to use this parce que is when you want to introduce the cause, la cause. Okay? Example here. Il prend son parapluie. Parapluie, umbrella. Prendre is to take. Il prend son, his. So he's taking his umbrella. Il prend son parapluie. Parce qu'il pleut. Pleuvoir to rain. It rains. il pleut. Il prend son parapluie parce qu'il pleut. Okay? And then, second example. Il appelle le garagiste parce que sa voiture ne démarre pas. Okay? A place to call. Garagiste is this nice person that will fix your car if it's broken or if it doesn't start, like in this example. Okay? Parce que sa voiture, voiture is car, sa voiture, possessive, his car, and then ne pas, so you get the negative form here, and démarrer is to start. Il appelle le garagiste parce que sa voiture ne démarre pas. So because his car doesn't start, okay? Il appelle le garagiste parce que sa voiture ne démarre pas. All right? So you can see the two main way of using this parce que. So the first one, the reason. In that case, well, it's something that refers to the person, okay? Actually, in that case, it doesn't. He doesn't eat because he prefers to wait, and then we go outside because we want, okay? And then the second possibility, when you talking about la cause, in that case, something that doesn't really, it's not the results of what someone is doing, but it's raining in that case, and then the car doesn't start. It doesn't really, it's not the result of the action of someone, okay? So that's the two main use of parce que. Then we'll work on le Moyen-Orient, the Middle East, okay? Let's start. Le Moyen-Orient. So it's interesting here because normally if you would have only this word here, you would pronounce it moyen, moyen, okay? But then as you've got this vowel after, okay, you've got to make the liaison between the two. Le Moyen-Orient, Moyen-Orient. Okay, let's start now. Israël, Israël. La Palestine, la Palestine. Le Liban, le Liban. La Jordanie, la Jordanie. Okay, so let's repeat them one more time. Le Moyen-Orient, Israël, la Palestine, le Liban, la Jordanie. Okay, and now we'll see the nationalities. Okay, so Israël, and then in, I will put the masculine form here and the feminine form here. Israélien, Israélien, so masculine form and then feminine form. Israélienne, Israélienne, okay, yen, yen, okay, and then Palestinien, Palestinien, feminine form, Palestinienne, Palestinienne. Le Liban, Libanais, né, né, Libanais, Libanaise, okay, et, aise, z, aise, Libanais, Libanaise. And then, Jordanie, Jordanien, Jordanienne, okay, yen, yen, Jordanien, Jordanienne. Okay, so let's see them one more time. Israël, Israélien, Israélienne. La Palestine, Palestinien, Palestinienne. Le Liban, Libanais, Libanaise. La Jordanie, Jordanien, Jordanienne. L'Extrême-Orient, so Far East. L'Extrême-Orient, so let's discover that together. So Far East in French, we'll say l'Extrême-Orient. L'Extrême-Orient. Le Japon. Le Japon. La Chine. La Chine. La Chine. L'Inde. So remember, you get this nasal here form. I-N-1. L'Inde. D. L'Inde. Le Pakistan. Le Pakistan. Hong Kong. Hong Kong. Okay, so let's see everything one more time here. L'Extrême-Orient, le Japon, la Chine, l'Inde, le Pakistan, Hong Kong. Okay, and now for the nationalities. So each time I will put the masculine form and the feminine form. Okay, le Japon, japonais, japonaise. Okay, so the only difference is there. Est, aise. Japonais, japonaise. La Chine, chinois. So it's really this wah 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 sound, remember? Chinois, chinoise. Z, z, oise, chinoise. So chinois, chinoise. L'Inde, indien, yin, indien, indienne. So remember this double N, you open it, E, indienne. Le Pakistan, pakistanais, pakistanaise. Hong Kong, chinois de Hong Kong, chinoise de Hong Kong. So let's see them one more time. Le Japon, japonais, japonaise. La Chine, chinois, chinoise. L'Inde, indien, indienne. Le Pakistan, pakistanais, pakistanaise. Hong Kong, chinois de Hong Kong, chinoise de Hong Kong. Le verbe pronominal. So, what is le verbe pronominal? So first we'll take an example. Regarder, to look, to watch. Okay? And then, se regarder. In that case, it would be to look at oneself. Okay? So that's the important thing about this. Verbe pronominal, le verbe pronominal will be constructed all the time with this se before the verb. Se regarder, okay? And this se will basically change the meaning of the verb because regarder, to look, to watch, se regarder, to look at oneself, okay? So we'll take an example. So if we take the regarder verb, okay? So normally you will construct this sentence, je regarde la télévision, okay? I watch the television. Je regarde la télévision, okay? But then, if you use this se regarder, so as I said, to look at oneself, in that case, je me regarde. Alright, so you will have to add this me thing here before the verb. Je me regarde. Okay? So let's see how we will conjugate this verb at the present form. Je me regarde. Tu te regardes. Il se regarde. Elle se regarde. Nous nous regardons. Vous vous regardez. Il se regarde. Elle se regarde. So now you can see that you've got to add this me, te, se, Nous, vous, ce. Before the verb. When you conjugate it. Okay? Let's take another example. Appeler, to call. Okay? And then the important thing in that case is that, as usual, you know, appeler is starting with a vowel. A, here. And it does mean that, as usual in French, normally we should have this se, but then e will disappear and it will look like that, s'appeler. So appeler to call and then s'appeler to call oneself. Okay, so let's see how we will conjugate this verb. Je m'appelle. So same thing here, the e that we had previously disappeared. Je m'appelle. So remember, that's normally the verb that you use when you introduce yourself, like I call myself, so my name is, of course, but then in French it's like I call myself. Okay, je m'appelle. Tu t'appelles. Tu t'appelles. Il s'appelle. Elle s'appelle. Nous nous appelons. Okay, so I will make the liaison. Nous nous appelons. Vous vous appelez. Il s'appelle. Elle s'appelle. Sorry. So if you look carefully here as well, so you will have to add this m, t, s. Okay, and then nous, vous, s. Okay, so remember, it's just because the verb is starting with a vowel. It would be the same if the verb would start with the letter H plus a vowel, because we don't pronounce H, so that's the reason why. My God, I'm losing my voice. Let's hope I will finish. be careful, because in some cases, when you will add this S in front of the verb, then le sens, so the meaning of the verb, will change. So I will put a few examples here. Trouver is to find, okay? And then se trouver means to be, être. Okay? Trouver, to find, but then se trouver is to be, être. Passer, to pass. Se passer, avoir lieu, so to take place. Se passer, to take place. Passer, to pass. Okay? And then, mettre, to put. Se mettre, well, it's to start. Commencer, to start something. Okay? So remember, trouver, to find. Se trouver, être, so to be. Passer, to pass. Se passer, avoir lieu, to take place. Mettre, to put. Se mettre, commencer, to start something.